only golpe which survived was the final thing is this name golpe diagonally played close to the beat. Emphasize notes either with this finger resting or free, but the proper angle of the thumb should be there, which means what? That this should be this way. All right. Now, that you also can check in other videos. This thing, this is one golpe, to emphasize notes like in. This is one time.
Yeah.
The only one to survive with the nail. Some people do also with ring finger, but now the modern technique, avoiding this nail thing is important. Also for strummings. If I do this nail, look. I don't know how to do it because I have also very short nail there, but it will sound too noisy. This sound, so it is zero nail.
And so this is the other golpe.
This is, yes.
This is the standard golpe.
The standard golpe will be this here, closer to the bridge, the tip of the bridge, and it's done with middle ring finger together flesh. So this is that. It's also not perpendicular to the top, but towards that direction, like this.
Yeah.
So then you have to also be careful to not play because in quantum you could analyze that actually both fingers together are not together and that actually are not contacting the empty because there are atoms in between. All that, right? So, but if you want to become a detailed guy here, if one finger is more, is the angle is wrong when you hit, this one will stop the vibration of the other one, and then it will produce this kind of dead sound like this. This, instead of that sound like this, a dead sound. So we need to practice first this here, only golpe, flesh middle finger. Then we have index down with free hand, index down and tapping with middle ring finger flesh.
Yeah, this is the third note. Yeah.
This is the third one, this.
So what do you call this one?
That is index down and tapping with middle ring finger flesh. That also exists sometimes with the thumb down and tapping here. Though here this thing is avoided a lot because it's prone to come nailed because of the angle of the attack.
Yeah.
While this here can keep more flesh sound because of this angle of the hand. So you have this, and with the thumb, well, that's not so powerful also because you have to put the stretch the fingers and the strength of this golpe is to have curve here in the shape of the hand. Relaxing the hand and not tensing is very important. And another is to not do it with muscle. You have to play this thing with the very weight of the hand. Look, do you see I did an impact or effort? Check it out.
Yeah.
I'm just leaving the hand fall with its own weight, and also the fact that try to avoid total perpendicularity in the golpe. So therefore, that's why. If you analyze, it's quite hard to avoid this golpe. Mainly because of the angle of the hand. Because thumb down makes you have the fingers like this to do the golpe. And this becomes a weird thing, a bit perpendicular. But it could be done also this way. Like this thing, but index down is much better. Now, when you play with index down, hand tapping with middle ring finger flesh, the index hits the 6th string in 6 feet 4 thirds this way.
Yeah.
We never play with the strummings or practicing the golpe, first and second string. This is very important because you will sound. So it always happens like this. Then we have the same tapping with middle ring finger flesh, but with the thumb resting on the 6th string. So this. For instance, sounds like this. Look, difficult to do this with the thumb here.
Yeah.
Because first we need to practice the other, but this one is also important for every palo, for instance, in Alegrías. You see this thing here, the acoustic image behind that of the rhythmical spectrum of this phrase, which with the strings output, with the chord bringing sound like this. You kind of not listen very well the golpe, but you listen it, you put attention, but because there are things there of the chord ringing, it's under, let's say, and the other is shining more. If I separate that and play it muted, when I am playing this, what happens under is this. It's too much what is going on there. If this is missing, you know how you will sound? You will sound like this. Instead of that is same like if in the drum set we take out the bombo, the bass drum, it will the groove will lose meaning.
What about the
unless
one
you are maybe con la yuta, I don't know who.
What about the one where you flick the top near the sixth string?
The golpe, that golpe there, which is also a Paco thing.
Yeah.
This in Cervica sound did not exist.
No.
Is to be careful about.
Yeah.
Some people who play for dance use it a lot. It's this thing. So practically speaking, is hitting with the index the top by the side of the sixth string and then move down the hand like this. So this. Yeah.
So play a note?
Sound like this is the this is going. Or with the middle.
Wow.
Eh? Because this will happen. I have a scar here of 20 years ago, it's still not going.
Wow.
This will have to be careful with this.
Yeah.
Because playing it in the tablao,
yeah,
you will use it a lot.
Yeah.
And then why? Because there is a bad sound, you are just playing this. Of course, if you do that without the pick guard, you will ruin the guitar.
Do you? So
try. Not here. Oh, play.
Well, I'm hitting this.
Mute properly the strings first. Out of the sound. Out now, do it.
Like that? No.
So yeah, that's what I show you. Yeah, but do I leave the hand there?
Like that?
Move the hand down. No, you need to listen to the sound. This is the sound. Maybe this.
I'm afraid of ruining
look, it. No, you do it. Look. Go, try.
So really,
and then we do a challenge. I do 30 of them.
My finger won't exist.
And then that doesn't sound. That is you are applying more strength there than the spot where you are playing. No.
What the
fuck? Yeah, sounds like actually this is this. So it's used to do some ending or right, this kind of things. Try.
And that's the middle finger, not the index. Am I using the right finger?
Use the index first.
The index.
This is because you are, first of all, you are doing a weird flick.
Yeah. How do you flick?
No, I'm flicking from here. Careful to not say this a pack of thing here. Careful. No. Look this. Don't put it too far. Also inside this one.
Okay.
Now. Okay. That is too base here. I don't feel the bright of that. Now try with the middle. That is also not right. Maybe this. Look. This sounds like this. With the index, so
what was I doing?
Index.
What was I doing?
I don't know. Something wrong for sure, but then you can learn the right thing. Is it? Because you have to hit the top. And then the problem, what is the problem? You are not hitting the top. That is a bit, it has to happen a bit flat surface with the nail and the top. That is better, but this is still not flat. That is better. No, wow. No, no. You have to keep here, but you have the string, and then what? Because you need to move the hand.
So is it up?
No, it will damage your to the skin of the finger. If you do this many of these things.
Is that better?
No. Look, look at this thing. Mira. Why? Because I'm getting, no, wait a moment. I'm getting this flat.
Yeah.
This has to be flat.
Okay.
And if you're going this way, yeah, it will never sound.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Now, because you need to also move the hand with the cord, there is no way you don't destroy this part of the finger. Mira, look at this. I have a still, look, if you see my fingers, there is a little bit here, you can see the color and this. This is from 20 years ago. In the tablao or playing for dancers in Madrid, so like this.
Okay.
The military services. So index, same sound.
So which one do you use? Index?
I don't use this.
Okay.
It's too much.
Okay.
This one here is for an ending.
And it doesn't matter where you hit?
No, it does matter. Don't use it where I am hitting. I am hitting right. The problem with this thing is you have to hit right close to the string. Now, no, drop the hand. Now you need to, that's right, you need to bring this part of the wrist further so that you can do that better. Because you reach flat. No. You are still diagonal. No. No, you need to, you hit it once. You hit once this. Steady this.
Fuck, man.
Alright, see this one. All right. This. Sorry. I don't know how to do, but that is too.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, no, this one. That is one more. What else?
There was one, which was. The one where you're
Doing
the table, like a tabletop?
That is right. Then there's another thing. The gypsies used to play on the table like this. This is the basic beat. This is the basic beat. Let me show you this one. With the metronome first, we go, and then we do 12. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, this will be 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, this is the beat. That also ruins your hand if you do it too much on the table and that. But Paco took that and put it in something like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Just for one detail, like playing it here, you have to put these two knuckles here. This, hitting like this. Like how you hit the door, this, and then drop the index flat to the top. This. Do it. No. Wait. This finger like this. Index. Oh no. Palm. This you have to hit with this part. That right. But that has to be musical, and not a strong. This palm. And then now, and then index drop. No, the index has to be flat. Same sound like the other word. But look. That's more or less. Look.
It's hard.
Ah, by the way, I will send you a special video, a private video of that. Because I have one series of 3 or 4 with this thing using with chords and that.
Does your hand slide when you knock, or is it just stationary?
No, it doesn't move. You just go to one.
Like that?
To one place.
No, not like that. Look.
Video like of golpe. Not. Now
you know, I don't slide like this, huh?
No, no, look. This is fixed. It's in, it was originally in the table.
Yeah.
Now they're also doing it in the caja. But this thing here, what Paco did, it's like playing, Paco put it from the table to this.
Yeah.
And then, for example, but the thing is, this has to hit flat,
yeah.
Just like this.
Okay. That's ridiculous. Thank you. Okay, good.
Pablo, Paco, ¿qué es para usted la música popular y qué es la música elitista?
Yo creo que la música elitista es el refinamiento de la música popular. Por ejemplo, el flamenco. El flamenco originalmente es una música popular, la música del pueblo de Andalucía. Pero creo que ya no le pertenece más al pueblo, porque de pronto habemos gente que nos hemos pasado toda una vida encerrados puliendo esa expresión popular. Entonces ha llegado a un nivel en el que el pueblo ya no tiene acceso, sobre todo a los matices que vamos consiguiendo la gente como yo, que nos pasamos muchas horas elaborando esa música.
En el loco que descubrí ahí la improvisación. La improvisación es algo que yo pienso que cada músico del estilo que sea, del clásico, del flamenco, de cualquier otra música, debería aprender, porque la improvisación te da mucha libertad y a la vez te da mucho conocimiento de dónde estás tocando y cómo estás tocando, de qué armonías están en cada momento, ¿no?